Aloha everyone, and welcome to another Carbon 60 video by me, Kay Elmer. And in this video, I'd like to share with you my ongoing experiments in using C60 topically. And specific to this video, I'll be talking about experiments that I've been doing using penetrators. And this is part two of a series on C60 topical that I didn't know I was going to make. So I don't know if there'll be a part three, but this is part two. So now, if you remember in part one, that's where, and oh, by the way, if you haven't seen that, link below, okay? But I covered essentially the usage of C60 in the cosmetic, industry. And it's been going on for about 20 years. So they've got a lot of experience and history behind them using it in cosmetics. And so I kind of just summarized that, and I also did a P60 experiment on myself in that video. Okay, so if you haven't seen it, I encourage you to see it. And if you if you don't care about seeing it, here's a little recap, and that's fine. The thing about it, and this is even why, why am I doing this, right? Well, why am I doing this is because C60 topical, putting it on your skin has some unique benefits that aren't necessarily the same as taking it via oil. Okay, and so I'm just tinkering, and I've been trying to figure out a much more effective and efficient process of getting a really solid dose of C60 through the skin. And so, but the research shows, and this is what I covered in part one, that it's really helpful for acne and skin aging, wrinkles and that sort of thing, reducing facial pores. And then here's this issue about barrier recovery. For those of you who are ingesting C60, you know that if you go out in the sun, you're not as prone to getting sunburn. But if you did get a sunburn and you put a C60 solution on you, that actually helps you recover faster and reduces the damage that the UVB radiation did to your skin. So, and that's just a few of the many wonderful things that C60 can do for your skin. So, that's kind of why I do these videos. I'm just really interested in, what else can it do and how else can I take it. So now let's jump into the content, but obviously before I do that, this material is for research purposes only. Carbon 60 is not approved for consumption by the FDA. You understand that applying C60 on your skin is experimental and you do so at your own risk. I do not endorse C60 products or C60 companies. I don't get paid in any way for making videos. I am simply sharing my research and my experiments with anyone who is willing to learn from them. So I'm happy to share. And above all, this is not medical advice in any way, shape, or form. So if you have any of the problems listed before I just said this slide, this is not medical advice. Okay, so let me jump in. Before I get going, one more time. I just want to say mahalo. Mahalo, Jeff, for helping out. In video part one on topical, Elton was instrumental in helping, and he just participated on all the experiments with me. And so it was really nice to just have someone who was doing it with me where I could ask questions and we could compare each other's results. And in this video, Jeff from the C60 chat group on Telegram was my collaborator, and thank you so much. You're most exceptional. I mean, it was really helpful, and we did everything from gather materials together to, do all the tests. So, mahalo, and thank you very much for helping. So, let me jump right in. So, first things first, right? What are penetrators? Well, it's basically this. And I found this really cool little video too I want to share with you. So, but the thing that is important whenever you get into trying to understand how to do anything topical is to understand how our skin works. And we basically have two layers. There's multiple layers in here, obviously, but this is the epidermal layer of our skin, and this is the dermis. Okay, so dermis and epidermis, you probably remember all that from school. So the greatest resistance to penetration of drugs or any kind of substance here is provided by the stratum corneum, which is the epidermal layer of our skin. It's kind of like our shield that keeps stuff from getting to us, which if you did get to us, you'd get right in here, straight into the bloodstream. And so this is the rate limiting step when you're trying to get stuff into your bloodstream. That's what's going to stop you. And so you need to find a way to get past this. So what penetration enhancers, and these are basically chemicals, are substances that assist in the absorption of the penetrant through the skin. Okay, and it is achieved by temporarily diminishing the impermeability of the skin. And that's what this little video shows. Kind of wanted to share it with you because you can take a look at, and this is an actual video, it's a commercial from another type of product, some kind of nanoparticle thing, but it's perfect diagram for what I wanted to, or you know, visual. So what happens is whenever you put anything on the skin, there's an effect that causes your skin to kind of basically emit fluid to kind of dissolve this stuff and get it off your skin through sweat, right? And then, so that's the first thing that's going to happen when you put C60 on your skin, is you get hydration. And then the second thing is because the penetrators start working at this level right here. So once the penetrator starts working in on this level of your skin, the corneum or the stratum corneum, then this thing becomes less impermeable or more permeable, meaning it starts to basically allow anything to just soak through like a sponge. And as it soaks, and as it does that, and actually when it finally finishes doing what it does, your skin completely returns to normal. It's like the shell again, right? But for just a little while, and these things work for just a short period of time, it allows anything that's sitting on it just to kind of soak in, and all of those nanoparticles will then soak in through the epidermal layer into the dermis, and then that's where all your capillaries are and straight into your bloodstream. So that's the whole idea behind penetrators. Penetrators are basically something that makes your skin a little bit more permeable to allow you to basically absorb whether they use drugs or whether they use substances. And the interesting thing in all of the research that I did for this was the science community has been just studying the heck out of this, and they've found ways to, and I've read all sorts of different ones, and it's anything from ibuprofen, minoxidil, naproxen sodium, and all sorts of different just regular drugs. They're basically experimenting with these penetrators to see if they can give you that drug just by putting it on your skin. And and I assume there are patients that just can't, for patients who can't take a pill or take anything through the mouth or the other end, it's like if you need to have a drug, why not just wipe it on your arm, kind of a thing. So there's a lot of research in the use of penetrators in the drug industry, and also, as you can imagine, in the cosmetic industry. And then the last general thing about penetrators is that they're all non-toxic. So if you there's plenty of studies in the links below, you can kind of read it yourself. They're colorless, they're tasteless, and they're odorless, except for DMSO, which tastes like garlic or smells like garlic. So here are my materials and methods for this set of experiments. And so what I chose to use, and it started from reading, there's a really good study, and it kind of kicked off the whole thing about wanting to give this a try. And that study is in the link below. But basically the study is called Permeation of Skin with C60 Fullerene Dispersions. All right. So if you check out that study, it basically said, the scientists took isopropyl mitrate and transcutyl, and they blended them together and they with C60, and then they put it on pig skin, and then they study it with all sorts of different tools, and they found that it actually just the skin absorbed the C60 into the dermis. So so that's kind of where this all started with, oh hey, why don't I try that, and I'll go get some of that stuff. And so with Jeff's help, I was able to source some transcutyl. I found the isopropyl mitrate on Amazon, of all places, and the DMSO was on Amazon as well. So let me just kind of cover this. This is isopropyl mitrate, transcutyl. Now, this is what I want to really, really emphasize about this. If you're going to do this at home, okay, which, at your own risk, okay, it is diethylene glycol monoethyl ether. Okay, that's the chemical name for transcutyl. But if you just buy this, which is what Jeff and I did by accident, we went and bought a bottle of this and we split it up, and he started using it, and then he did the research and discovered that if it's not the highest purity you can get, meaning the one we got was 98% purified, but even that 98%, it still has a trace element of a toxic chemical, a solvent in there. And so we don't want, neither one of us wanted to have any solvents on us. So we found out, and we went and found that actual transcutyl is a separate product made by a company that I don't remember how to pronounce in France. And they purify this chemical to 100%. And once you purify it to 100%, then it's non-toxic and it's safe. So just a heads up there, don't, because if you type in transcutyl on Amazon, which is what happened, then diethylene glycol monoethyl ether pops up, and I ordered a bottle of that because I thought that was transcutyl, but it's not. Transcutyl is transcutyl. Okay, so real important because it's toxic if you don't get purified. So it's got to be this specific name. So I just really want to emphasize that. And then, of course, DMSO. Many of you are familiar with that, dimethyl sulfoxide. And so I use some of that. And then, of course, pulverized C60 from Red Lion. So these were my materials that I used. And so then my methods was simply this. Now, I added pulverized C60 to all three penetrators, and the first one was a mirror of the study that I had mentioned earlier, with basically they had three different things that they did, and I grabbed the one that they did in the middle one, which was 80% isopropyl mistrate with 20% transcutyl. Okay, so that was the first experiment. The second one was using 100% transcutyl just all by itself. And then I stirred for 2 weeks, and then I let it sit for a week, okay, just to see what would happen. And then the third one, which when I had the DMSO, this is actually from an earlier experiment that I did when I tested, how does DMSO react to C60? And so I used 100% DMSO, which normally, you never want to put that on your skin, as Jeff unfortunately found out. But I used 100%, put it with C60. Of course, I didn't stir. I just put it in a test tube, shook the crap out of it vigorously, and then I let it stand. And I just to see, what would happen. And I was pretty convinced ahead of time that it wasn't gonna dissolve from what I was reading anyway. So I didn't want to bother stirring because I knew it wouldn't dissolve into each other. And so that was how I basically did it. And then this is just an example of my PC60 that I do. Whenever I used to get an old bottle like that, I'd put them all in syringes. But I work out of syringes, by the way. Syringes are the way to go. If you do anything like I'm doing, use syringes. It's so much easier. Okay, so moving on. Now, the experiment that I did with the 80% isopropyl mistrate and the 20% transcutyl, okay, so the quantities that I used my 50 milliliter beakers, and so what I did was I basically did an 80-20 IP&T solution, okay, and then I added the PC60. So I added 3 milliliters of PC60, which is in 100% alcohol, to the solution to make a total of 53 milliliters. Covered it up and let it stir. It just turns black. And then after the 2 week stir, I stopped the spinner and let it sit. And within 24 hours later, the next morning, I look at this thing and it just immediately just sunk to the bottom and just left this purple liquid. And this purple liquid even got lighter over time. So bottom line is isopropyl mistrate is a really bad solvent or penetrator to use. And when I say bad, I mean it just doesn't hold in solution at all. So so all of this piece, basically the pulverized C60 is just sitting in the bottom. But as I came to find out when I tested this stuff, that it's not just P60 down here, it's P60 mixed with this stuff. Because PC60 is mixed with alcohol when you buy it. And so that this had a whole effect that I didn't expect. So this was what that looked like when I made it. And then the second one where I made the PC60 with 100% transcutyl, I used 50 milliliters of transcutyl, and then I added 3 milliliters again of the PC60, and that's 500 milligrams. So for those of you who are doing the math in your head, yes, that is 0.5 gram of C60 in 50 tiny milliliters. That is 10 times the amount used in oil. And why did I do that? Well, I kind of did it by accident. I thought I was putting in a quarter because you're dealing with milliliters instead of grams. And so when I did the first one that way, I had to do the second that way for apples and apples, right? So anyway, I didn't plan to put in that much, but it's amazing what happened, because look what happened. This was the day I took it off the stir. Okay, it turned black just like the other one. But then after I let it settle, like within 24 hours, it was just this milky brown. And then there's right here, I don't see if you can see it. It's really hard to see. It's really still hard to see. But right here is like a half a milliliter to a milliliter, just like layer of black. And so some of the C60, not a lot, but some of the C60, whoops, I'm just getting out of range here. Some of the C60 actually, settled to the bottom, right? But the majority of the C60 held in solution. And that is a huge deal. And the reason that it's such a big deal for me is because here we are. We found a penetrator that will hold C60, meaning that, you know, it won't just, you just won't just, you know, fall out of it. So, and that's a big deal because, you know, that's the whole point, right? Trying to find something that'll hold it. So, so you can add it to other stuff and put it on your skin or just do it on your skin raw. So that's what happened when I made that one, and that was pretty cool. And then the other one too, now this is just to show you, right? My other experiment, this was in the video called The Six Experiments. This was in the video called, the one about the PC60 when I had to reconstitute it. Anyway, so, but this one was where I took basically 1 milliliter of PC60, which is about 167 milligrams, and I added it to 5 milliliters of DMSO, pure DMSO. Shook it, I think I shook it like 3 times, let it settle for, you know, all that time. So it was like over the course of a week. And basically, no matter what, though, when as soon as I let it settle, it just separated out. The C60 would just fall to the bottom. But what was interesting on the third try of doing this, the third, you know, shake the crap out of the test tube, I actually got this black foamy stuff. And I thought this was an actual physical substance, you know, meaning that what I did was I wanted to put that on my skin to see what would happen because I'm stupid. So I stuck a syringe down that test tube and I tried to pull this part out of it and nothing came up. So it's there, you can see it, but you can't suck it into a needle. It was syringes. So it's just, it's really weird. So this is, I don't know what this is. Obviously it's 660 with DMSO, but you know, I don't know what it is. So, but this is the DMSO and clearly it doesn't hold, you know, just like this one, it doesn't hold. This one doesn't hold. So I didn't have a lot of high hopes for these and how they would turn out after doing experiments, but this one did. And so that's pretty cool. So, now, as I mentioned, I put everything into the syringes so I could easily move them around and do stuff with them. So my experiments, there was 5 of them, and I basically made sure to rest a day, you know, 2 days between each experiment because I wanted to just get a, you know, like a, that whole 10-hour thing, you know, that C60 kind of comes out of you. I don't want to go there. That's a whole nother video. But the whole idea was, you know, give it a 2-day break and then do a test and give it a 2-day break. So that's kind of what I've been doing for the last 3 weeks. And so as I've been taking these things, I have 5 different experiments that I did I'd like to share with you. First thing I did was I wanted to patch test the mixtures. And in my lab, a la kitchen, I patch test everything, you know. I put a little bit on me, and then, you know, see if it, like, you know, I get a red mark, or, you know, what happens, right? I don't want to do my whole leg or something before I know what happens. So I just test it, you know, what's it going to do to me? Is it going to give me a welt, you know? And just a little bit. So I did a little bit of all of the mixtures, and I'll show you that here. And then, of course, what was interesting is because this 80-20 mixture here kept separating no matter what I did, it would separate, you know, within 12-18 hours it's separated, so it just wouldn't hold. So what I decided to do was, like, okay, why don't I try the top portion? So I tried this portion separately, and then experiment number 3 was I tried the P60 mixed with this stuff, heavy, you know, way more dense mixture down here. So I tried the bottom portion as a separate experiment on myself. And then the 4th experiment was, this is the transcutal mixture, the 100%. As you can see, no matter what you do, it just holds it. And then lastly, it was the DMSO. Now, one of the things about the DMSO, as I mentioned earlier, was Jeff had done an experiment. You know, he was doing his own experiments along the side with me, and we're collaborating on this thing. And so, well, by the way, I just want to point out that all of these mixtures up here, I just thought of that, all of these mixtures, I used pulverized C60. And so I just want to point out, Jeff used powdered C60 and had the same results. Okay, so it's not specific to pulverized C60. So I just want to point that out. Very important little point. Glad I remembered it. Okay, so what I did with the DMSO, now what Jeff had done was he put some C60 on his skin, and he mixed it and he put in some DMSO at full strength, and it turned really red and I think it was hurting. And so he did not like that. That was a very negative reaction. Don't do that, warned me, and I didn't. So what I did was, when I finally got it, you know, this took a couple of months, we've been doing this, right? So over the 2 months, he warns me about it. So I decided that after I'd already done this experiment, but I decided I did not want to use 100% DMSO. So I went with a 50-50. And so I went into the literature, and it's you dilute DMSO with distilled water. So I went ahead and did a 50-50. Most of the literature says it's okay at 70-30, but I didn't want to take a chance after hearing the description of what happened to Jeff. So I just went with a 50-50. And so because, and then again, experiment number five, because I know that it just doesn't, you know, it's not going to hold together very well. It's going to end up like this. So I decided, why bother mixing them? Again, you know, that was my old experiment. And so I just have the 50-50 DMSO in this syringe, and I have just a little syringe here of the pulverized C60. So I'll show you that experiment. So these are the five experiments that I did over the last few weeks, and I just simply just go ahead and share that with you, what happened and how I did it. So the only white place I could find on my body that's appropriate to show in a video is the top of my knee, you know, basically where my shorts are. It's the only part of my body is white. I'm outside a lot. So I use the white parts on my legs so you can see the color. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to see the color differences. And so the 80-20 mixture, now when I shook it up and I put it out, it was kind of this globby stuff, right? And it is like, this didn't look good. And then, of course, the transcutal mixture right here. So let me see if I can adjust the... And so this is the transcutal mixture by itself, and it's that chocolate milk colored stuff. And then I use these waterproof dressings to kind of hold it in place for a few hours. And then I took off the dressings. And what happened when I took off the dressing on the 80-20 mixture, the dressing took most of the C60 off of it, but it still had some residue C60, residual C60, as you can see from this coloration. And even Jeff reported that he, when he puts it on his skin, and he must be way whiter than me because he could see it. I can't see it on me, but he says that even when he uses the transcutal mixture, he still sees this brown coloration of the skin. So I'm going to stop here. I want to point out what I just said was it will leave a residual, you know, kind of coloration on your skin. So if you're thinking about putting it on your face, heads up, it will, you know, it will leave a color. And so you probably may or may not want that, but, you know, just it's something to consider. But when I did it, because I'm kind of dark and I use this waterproof bandage, there was nothing. So I think the bandage took it off, but it's so watery, and I couldn't even tell, but there's nothing there after I took it off. And this was 4 hours, okay? And then after a day, you know, days went by and nothing happened. My skin never turned red and never got itchy, so perfectly fine. I was happy and moved on. And so now my next test was the bottom portion. So I'm sorry, let me jump back and kind of clarify something. I only have pictures for the patch test, the bottom portion, and the 50-50. And the reason I only have pictures for that is I forgot to take pictures for the number two. Sorry. And for the transcutal mixture, and which is kind of the same as the number two, the 80-20 top portion, this guy and this guy, when I put them on my legs, it was kind of like there's nothing to take a picture of. I would have just took a picture of my leg. You couldn't tell. You know, I apply it to my legs, but you couldn't see it. It was kind of, it's so clear, it just disappears. So there's really nothing to show, but I did kind of mess up. And sorry about that there, but I do try to include pictures on all my experiments. So so I just had the patch test, and then so this one was the bottom portion right here, was this experiment. So now, you know, it's so dark, you can see. And so what I did was I put 1 milliliter on each calf, and I rubbed it in, okay? And so when I rubbed it in, you know, I definitely, it was like, it was... There's, it got on my hand, but I got this whole part of my leg covered with this mixture, the 80-20, the bottom portion now where the PC60 sunk. And then, so I got a lot on my hand and I got a lot on my leg. And then, of course, I didn't think about the whole oxidation thing. I didn't read that study before I did this test. And so anyway, so once I read that study, it's like, oh, you should take this off a lot sooner. But I actually left it on and removed it in the shower the next day. Okay. And then, so for the last one that I can show you is the when I did the 50-50 DMSO experiment. And so when I did that experiment, I want to point out something about messing around with PC60 is I use a 3-inch 13 gauge blunt needle to move it around, like to take it out of a bottle, you know, and or put it in oil, you know, and so it's big gauge. The hole is bigger in the needle and it's blunt. You can't stab yourself. And so that's what I use with all my syringes. And I'm not sure what Red Lion sends out now because they're sending product out in syringes. So I'm not sure with you know, what needle they have. This is my own stuff. And so when I get my order, by the way, I will share what it looks like and stuff. But so what I did was I went out and I got this other needle here, this yellow one, and it's a 22 gauge needle. And these are all lure locks. That's what it's called, a lure lock, and it just screws right onto the end of a syringe. And so I use this guy whenever I'm like dosing C60 on my skin, because this guy, you cannot control the amount of any fluid that comes out because the gauge is so big. But when you get really, really tiny, like a small hose as opposed to a full-on garden hose, you can really control the dosage, the amount of drops that comes out. So I use this smaller one. Highly recommend that you use a small needle whenever you're trying to dose. Okay, so that's a little pro tip there. And so basically I used a 22 gauge needle, this yellow one, and I put 5 little drops on the back of my hand. And so yeah, when you're doing pure C60, you know, I don't recommend putting it all over your legs. So I just did 5 little drops, and what's amazing is how much C60 is in those 5 little drops. That's what that looked like. And then I let the alcohol evaporate, which literally, it happened so I couldn't even count the seconds. It was like maybe I was reaching over and I did something. I looked back and boom, it was done. It was like literally 10 seconds. The alcohol just immediately evaporates off. And then I put 5 small drops, a drop of the 50-50 DMSO on each dot. And then I smeared it across I tried to smear it up and down where you see this one vein coming across, because I wanted as close to the bloodstream as possible. And then I removed it after 4 hours for oxidation purposes. Okay, and so that's kind of what this looks like at a close range. This is what the 5 drops look like. And what was real interesting was that this stuff dries so fast that before I can even put the drops of the DMSO on the drops of PC60, the little tips were falling off. So that one fell off onto the table. This one fell off on the table, and this one just popped off and was laying next to the where I had originally put it. And with this little cap of the dried C60. So I've learned that the next time I do this is use only maybe like 1 little drop, and then smear, you know, use the needle or something, use a device to kind of smear it into the crevices of my skin, and then try DMSO. That's my idea here, because this kind of didn't really go the way I wanted, but that's the results of the test. So then I smeared it across my hand, and look how much these 5 tiny drops. And how much C60 that is. It was just this huge amount. And I used this guy, and I just ran it sideways across my arm like that, boom, and I just smeared it out there. And I just let it sit there for 4 hours, and then I took it off. And so what's interesting is that when I took it off, you can see that, you know, this amount of P660 on the napkin compared to what was originally in here. So, you know, there's quite an amount that was actually absorbed by my hand. So it definitely works, but does it work better than the other ones? Let's talk about that. So these are the results. So before I get into results, I think it's real important that you understand my concept, or you know, because that's what I'm measuring it against, of effective dosage. And so in my world, in my mind, that an effective dosage of C60 is not a certain amount of milligrams or a certain amount of milliliters of oil. It is how I feel. So my effective dosage is anywhere in between these two points of existence, where I don't feel anything at all, like nothing's happened different in my world. And then I get to the point where if I take too much, I can't sleep. It really messes with my sleep. You know, wake up at 3, wide awake, you know, ready to go, but it's 3, you know. So that's the range. And so it can go anywhere in here, and depending on how much you take, but my goal is always to hit this right here. And that is my idea of an effective dosage is where I have sustained energy and sharp mental acuity all day. So whatever, depending, every single thing you buy, every batch you make is going to have a different effective dosage. And so for me, you know, I do this hermetic thing where I kind of try different, you know, I change it up all the time so that I can find out, like if I make a specific batch and of olive oil or whatever, I keep taking different dosages until I find the effective one. And sometimes it could be 2 tablespoons, sometimes it could be 1, You know, and then in when it comes to topical, it'll be the same thing. So that's how I work. That's how my brain works when it comes to this. So this is what I did for the experiments, okay? There's the five experiments right here. These were the doses. So when I did the patch test, it was about a half a milliliter, both legs, no negative reactions. And then again, remind everybody, do not use 100% DMSO. Now, when I used the top portion of the 80-20, this purpley colored liquid here, it looks really weird against the paper for some reason. It was the color of the light. I didn't feel anything. I mean, I covered both calves, 1 milliliter each calf, zero, nada, nothing. It was like I didn't do it all at all. And so then I tried the bottom portion of the 80-20 mixture. That was just PC60. And as I alluded to earlier, I was just, and that's 1 whole milliliter, both legs, even with some of it rubbing off on my hand, I was amped up for 2 days on 5 hours of sleep. I was amped up that whole day that I took it. I slept only 5 hours and I wasn't really good sleep. The next day I was amped up the whole next day. So that was like, okay, I kind of hit this here. I took too much of that one. And this guy, I took way too little. So that's how this little thing works. That's how my brain works, okay? So this was pretty intense, okay? And then, so, you know, we now have learned that PC60 with a penetrator is very intense. And so you need to watch your dosage on that. Learn something new. Now, the transcutal mixture was interesting as well. I took a full milliliter on both legs, rubbed it in, and I got an effective dosage. It was like, you know, like the Goldilocks, right? It was just right. And so I totally felt it. But it didn't mess with my sleep. I had a decent night's sleep that night. I had sustained energy, and I was just really sharp. I mean, I was at work, and it kind of got irritating for people I work with because I just kept sending everybody all these emails following up on this. It was like, man, you know, enough already today, you know. So it was like I was very, very on it, but I wasn't like hyper like on coffee. So it was like perfect. It was like the perfect dosage for me. And you know, you got to remember too, I put half a gram in that 50 milliliters, so that was like almost like 0.1, you know, one, like 100, I think it's, well, not off the top of my head, but it's definitely 10 times more power, you know, more, I guess, higher dosage of C60 per milliliter than oil will ever be. So it's pretty, you get a really good dose. That's, I guess, what I'm saying. The last experiment was the 50-50 DMSO. I put 5 little drops, and you know, you'd think that with the DMSO and all of this and da 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 da, that, you know, honestly, I took it in the morning, and by late afternoon, I was tired. I just was tired, and I wasn't tired like that with these other two. So I was surprised at the DMSO, but then, you know, again, when you think about it, and if this is the reaction you have with DMSO and C60, is it really a surprise that it, you know, that it doesn't work as well as any of the other two penetrators? So it didn't really work that well. So I'm not that thrilled with the DMSO in terms of using that with C60, but with the transcutal mixture or with the 80-20 mixture, yeah, you know, there's something definite, something that you want to look into or try yourself if you're a tinkerer. So now between Jeff and I, we've done this for a few months, and we kind of collected what we've learned from this, and this is the slide for that. The success factors for producing your own C60 topical solution is hydration. Hydration is key. And you know, Jeff cannot stress this enough. He actually mists his skin with water before and after. I think before and after. Definitely after. And so I do it like fresh out of the shower when my skin is really hydrated, right? But either way, you know, if you're hydrated, this will work so much better. If you notice, if you're putting it on dry skin, I don't think you'll get any response at all. It's just your skin won't be able to absorb it. And that just makes sense, right? A wet sponge sucks water faster than a dry sponge, right? I think. Kind of. Okay, so anyway, on the apply on thin skin. As I was reading studies about C60 and fullerene permeability on skin, it was really clear in the literature that obviously C60 is insoluble in water, but it was clear in the literature, it actually said it, that, you know, that when they watch C60 seep through skin, that the fat cells, which are mostly water, when the C60 hits a layer of fat, it disperses into the fat and it doesn't go any deeper into the skin. So you really need to think about that In terms of where you put it. So that's why I was applying it on thin skin. My calves are really close. I'm really, really got my veins are close to my skin on everybody on their calves. And then, of course, the top of the back of my hands, my wrists, and then Elton liked to use the crook of his elbow. But these are places where, if you can see the vein at the skin, that's where you want to put topical C60, okay? Don't put it anywhere like on your belly, because once it hits that fat layer, boom, it's game over, okay? Now, the other thing, too, is there's a study I read where the repetitive flexing motion increases the rate which particles transverse the dermis. And so what that means is just move around. Your skin moving back and forth is going to actually cause the C60 to move better. It's going to increase the rate at which it's actually going to get absorbed into your skin. So that was interesting. Another couple of studies I read was avoiding UV light, that C60 will definitely oxidize in direct sunlight. So you must not put it on and go out in the sun, okay? Because once C60, which is the super antioxidant, that's the reason we all take it. But if it gets oxidized, it becomes a pro-oxidant, and it does the exact opposite of what it does when it's not. So you don't want it to do that, because if it's a powerful antioxidant, you can imagine that it's also going to be a powerful pro-oxidant, and it will mess you up. So you don't want to go out in the sun. So if you're going to do it, that's the reason I did my legs, because I had to go to work. So I figured, I can put it on something. I can, with my pants on, I'm in the office. Even if I go out to my car, whatever, it's not going to be in the sun. So that's why I did my calves. Now I did the back of my hand because I knew I was going to be home all that day. So there you go. Keep out of light. Or you can just wear UV protective clothing. That's one way to do it. And then the other thing too is when you have C60 on your skin like this, then you basically, or like this other picture here, like right here, when you have C60 on your skin, it's really important to remove it after 4 hours, because at 4 hours is about the time where the C60 will begin to oxidize with the air. And the air, obviously, it's oxygen, O2. What is C60? Well, it's an electron donor, and it loves oxygen. It loves oxygen so much. If an oxygen molecule comes near two C60 molecules, the two C60 molecules will grab one molecule, one atom of oxygen each, and they'll just like combine together like two big soccer balls with a little tennis ball in between. Okay, that's what happens. If you just read all the studies. it oxidizes pretty quickly. And after 4 hours, it's like, hey, man, get it off your skin, okay? For the same reason about the light. So really important stuff. And I kind of want to add one thing I just was thinking about. Yes, you can put C60 oil on your skin and not have to do this whole experiment. But then what fun would that be? And you wouldn't get a video. I've actually looked into C60 oil on skin, and that's going to probably be coming up in another video. Like, what is the best oil? So stay tuned for part 3 of a series I didn't know I was going to do. So lastly, I did this video a little bit differently because there's so much content about the experiments. I just wanted to share that with you, and I didn't want to spend too much of your time going through stuff you could read if you wanted to. So I did, but I just want you to know I did a ton of research. This is just a little tiny tip of the iceberg about it, but all of these studies are in the links below. And I highly recommend, if you're interested in this, this one is the permeation of skin. That's the one with the 80-20 mixture that they did. There's a whole study about isopropyl mistrate, and then there's a whole study on the permeation properties and penetration properties of transcutal. Okay, and then there's a solvation property of C60 in DMSO. So these first four are the crux of this particular video. But I did a lot of reading for several weeks to just kind of figure out what this was all about, and then what to do, what not to do, and so forth. So if you are interested in more, just go check the video links and then have at it. Okay, so that's it. Thank you for watching my video. This is just me tinkering around, trying some different stuff. We learned some new stuff, and I'm actually seriously thinking about probably keep doing it, because I still have that big bottle. And so, you know, I'm actually going to continue to take C60 topical as just a kind of like the whole, you know, Hermosis thing, where I want to just, you know, I want to change it up all the time, you know, to make my body, you know, have to just adjust and get used to different things and not ever fall in, you know, get complacent, right? So I really got some value out of this, and I'm definitely going to keep making topical C60 solutions. And for those of you who want to give it a try, here's this video. Thank you again for your support. Thank you for your kind comments. I never tire. Thank you. I really do really, really appreciate it, because it's nice to be appreciated for your work, right? So thank you again for your time. I know you're busy. I need to let you go. By the way, last thing, if you have any questions about making C60 oil or about topical C60, you know, Jeff's in the chat room. Ask Jeff a question. Ask me a question. I'm there. He's there. Everybody else is there. So you're always welcome to join our chat group. Link in the description below. All right. So, hey, thanks for watching my video. Have a great day. Aloha.